गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ योर पॉलिटिकल साइंस चैप्टर टाइटल डेमोक्रेसी एंड डाइवर्सिटी. इन सेकेंड पार्ट, इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैव नोटेड डाउन एंड अंडरस्टूड द इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशन एंड टर्म्स रिगार्डिंग डेमोक्रेसी एंड डाइवर्सिटी. एंड नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू द नोट्स एंड एक्सप्लेन द इम्पॉर्टेंट इंसिडेंट एंड द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट दिस चैप्टर, we are here in this chapter are going to study the case study of Mexico, that how in USA the, you can say, the vibes of you can say civil rights movement started. We come to know through this case study of Mexico Olympic, and then we come to know that how the people of South Africa, especially African American, charged with the civil rights movement and they fight for their freedom and equality. Now, so before it, first of all, we need to understand what is all about the story of Mexico Olympic. So here we are going to know about the story of Mexico Olympics. Olympics, that it is a story of two gentlemen who are black, you can say, you can say they are African American, that and they were the athlete. Then how they show their poverty, especially the discrimination of the black in the USA through this platform, that you come to know that in Mexico Olympic in 1968 Olympics for 200 meter race was held in Mexico. During the award ceremony, two men named Tommy Smith and John Carrolls were standing with clenched fists, upraised, and their heads were bowed. That in 1968 in Mexico, the Olympic was organized, and during the award ceremony, these two, Tommy Smith and John Carrolls, who were the black, you can say, black American or African American, they were showing their gesture to recognize themselves that how discriminately they were treated, their whole community were treated in USA after spending so many years. So they were having a different sort of posture, body language, that they standing when the award was given to them, then they were standing at the podium with the clenched fist and upraised, and their heads were bowed. Third, that how they show their discrimination, they both were African American. They both were African American athletes. So here in the story, there are, one is Tommy Smith, and second John carols, these two figures, Mexico Olympic 1968, they both were African American athlete. And Tommy has won gold medal, while John Carroll's was won bronze medal. Bronze medal. Then what had happened that they both were suffering for a long period of time discrimination, racial discrimination, and that's why they were appearing when they were going to receive their awards. They were having no shoes. They were having no shoes and they were wearing black socks. Why they were having black socks? With the help of black socks, they want to represent poverty. Poverty. They want to represent poverty among the African American in USA. Then what had happened that through their clenched fists, and black socks without shoes, they wanted to attract the attention of whole world towards their discrimination in the USA. And discrimination, whose discrimination? Black African Americans discrimination. Then during the medal ceremony in 1968, medal ceremony, they were not only two people. That medal ceremony, and it was 1968 again, that there were three people. That John Smith, and then bronze Carlos, and the second one who has won the silver medal, he was Peter Norman, and he was the white Australian athlete. So when John Smith and John Carlos, or you can say Tommy Smith, his name is John and Tommy, sorry, it is a Tommy Smith and John Carlos, both were African American, and they want to cater the attention of the worldwide towards the discrimination of black native, that African American. At the same time, the another athlete whose name was Peter Norman, and he was white Australian, he was also supporting them. Although the Peter was not belong to the African category or African American, but still as a human being, as a understanding person, he supported these two athletes and he was in the favor of them. That's why when Peter Norman went to receive his award, means silver medal, He was wearing human rights badge on his shirt. He was wearing human rights badge on his shirt to support these two athletes. Peter Norman was wearing that human rights badge on his shirt. It is all about the story that how the Peter Norman, who was not the African American, but still he was in the favor of these two guys. So at the international level, Tommy Smith and John Carlos was so, you can say, gutsy. They didn't think that they maybe lost their medals. After this incident, they were criticized by the Olympic Association. Their medal was taken away and they were not awarded. They were criticized in media and the government also. Even the Peter Norman was also criticized by the Australian, you can say, government. And now the result of their action. Now the result that how the association, Olympic Association, punished them, how the government criticized them. The result is that the International Olympic Association criticized Carols and Smith and punished them as guilty of violating the Olympic spirit. That the Olympic Association found that they both were guilty. They found that they were making a political statement on this sports field. That's why they found them guilty. So first, their medals were taken away. Taken back. It was a result that they both have to face. Second, not only they, but the Peter Norman also suffered as he has banned in Australian team for next year's Olympic. Next year Olympic. So it was a story of Mexico Olympics in 1968, that how these two black African American joined hands and to show that how for a long period of time the African American was treating discriminately in the providing the facility by the government and the security and the facility, so many things, job availability, opportunity, that and they found that these medals are not important for them, as this is the chance where they can show their poverty, their discrimination at the international level. That's why they have done so. And at the same time, the another athlete, the Peter Norman, who was Australian guy, he was also support them as a human being, that they were right. So that's why he was also suffered. He was not allowing by the Australian government for the next year Olympic. Anyhow, these were the all the, you can say, incident which was held, which spread the feeling of civil rights movements among the whole African people, African American people in the USA. But then what had happened later? But although they were suffered so much, they were criticized in media, they were punished, they were punished by the government and the other authority, but finally they got success. They got success in gaining international attention for the civil rights movement, that by these two guys, the civil rights movement, it means that as a civilian in a nation, as a citizen of a nation, we all are equal, that we should be treated by the government equally. With equal, you can say, we are having the power, or you can say rights, to live our life freely, that and equally. So that's why that after this incident, the internationally they were noticed, that these black African community noticed internationally that really they need to come up with the civil rights movement, and they were supported by the every citizen of the nation. Now what had happened? That after that they became Tommy Smith and John Carroll's, they became the beginner of civil rights movement in USA, and this is their achievement, that how that every good thing, beta, always remember, every good and new thing at first criticized by the people, but if we are right and we know that we are doing good in the society, as Swami Vivekananda ji has quoted, that every good attempt is criticized first by the society, but if we are right and we are truthful, then definitely it is accepted by the people after some struggle, and then they follow you. So you should be quite confident, if you are doing good, then definitely you will be accepted by the society after some time. And it has happened in the case of Peter Norman and these two African athletes, that after some time, San Jose State University honored them for their bravery and the university installed their statue in the university campus. That even today you can see that these three athletes' statue was statue has installed in the university named Jan Soss State University in USA. It shows that that the in history they create the significance, they create their importance, that how important they are, whatever they have done for the civil rights movements, and even that the generation, the upcoming generation, knowing them, the students who are studying there, that how grateful the African community, that now they are enjoying the equal rights and opportunity in the USA, which earlier they were not blessed. So it is all about the case study of Mexico Olympics. Now, the another important topic in this lecture, three main factors. Three main